Hi, I'm Johnny, and today we have Kettleplex Double Down. It's an advanced kettlebell workout that uses two kettlebells. It's gonna kick our butt, but first, let's warm up. I've got five exercises in my warm-up. I've got the two-hand kettlebell swing, the one-arm kettlebell swing, the clean, the alternating one-arm swing, and the clean and press. Now, I've got two kettlebells that I'm gonna use for my warm-up. The first time that we go through each of these exercises, we're gonna do each exercise for 40 seconds, taking a 15-second break between each one, and I'm gonna use my lighter kettlebell weight through those 40-second exercises. The second time through the warm-up, I'm gonna go up to a heavier weight, and instead of a timed interval for each exercise, I'm just gonna do 10 repetitions of each one. Don't worry, you don't have to remember all of that. Just stay up and hang with me if you can. The two-hand swing is first. I already have my timer set up. I'm gonna get it started. Get ready, get set, let's go. Hike the kettlebell back through the legs and thrust with the hips. Coordinate your breath with the movement. Exhale on the thrust. You don't have to go incredibly low on the downswing, just low enough to let the kettlebell drop right between the legs. The handle of the kettlebell should be above the knees. Avoid hyperextension of the spine as you come upright. Squeeze the belly, squeeze the glutes to provide support to the spine and lower back. Keep the shoulders back, chest up, spine nice and long. All right, 15 seconds here, we're going to the one-arm swing. I like to start with my non-dominant arm. Get set up. And go. Let the free hand join in the movement. Avoid placing the hand on your hip or on your thigh. Try to keep the chest squared forward. Try to avoid too much rotation, even though one side of your body is weighted here. All right. We got the other side for the one-arm swings. Get ready. To the clean for the next exercise. Set the kettlebell up between your feet, internal rotation of the thumb, power up from the hips, tight rack at the top, thumb to collarbone, biceps to ribs, back to the floor. Loose grip in the hand is a key to getting the kettlebell to wrap around the forearm without banging into it. Internal rotation, external rotation. Head and chest stay up, back nice and flat. We've got the other side. Internal rotation of the arm, hips sink low, power up, loose grip, into the rack. We've got the alternating one arm swing. Switch hand positions when the spine is fully extended. Avoid switching hand positions when you're bent over and compromise the lower back that way. So, spine fully extended, switch hands before gravity begins to pull the kettlebell back to the floor. Again, I'm going to start with my non-dominant arm. You get to choose which arm you start with first. Set up. Clean. Press. Back and down. Each part has its own cadence. One, 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 one. One more side of this 40-second interval with the lighter weight, and then we're going to move on up to our heavier weight and do 10 repetitions going back through this warm-up sequence one more time. Sip of water if you need to, and grab your heavier weight if you have one. I've got my heavier weight. Let's go back to these 5 warm-up exercises. We're just going to do 10 repetitions of each one. Two-hand swing is first. Get set up. 3, 2, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, and 10. Come up, take a breath in, let a breath out. One arm swing, non-dominant arm. 3, 2, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Set the kettlebell down, come up, take a breath in, let a breath out. Other arm, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Breathe in, breathe out. We've got the clean. Set it up between your feet. Handle splits the midsection of your foot. And let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Come up. Breathe in. Breathe out. Set up and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, Come up. Breathe in. Breathe out. Alternating one arm swings. Get ready. Let's go. There's one. And one. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. Clean and press. Last one of the warm-up. Get ready. And go. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Breathe in. Breathe out, other side, and go. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. That's the warm up. Towel off, grab a sip of water if you need to. I'll come back and we'll go over the exercises. We've got three exercises in this first set. We've got the clean, the squat, and the press. Now, the fundamentals are the same as they are with single kettlebell work, except when you're using double kettlebells, you really got to focus on the form even more so, just to protect yourself and be safe. So with the clean, line the kettlebells up between your feet. The handles should split the midsection of your feet. Internally rotate the arms so the thumbs point back between the legs. Draw the shoulder blades back. Lift your chest. Make sure the spine is nice and flat. Get power and momentum from the hips. Loose grip with the hand. Clean up into a tight rack position. The thumbs are in close to the collarbones and the biceps are in tight to the ribs. And reverse the movement all the way back down. Keep the head and chest up so the spine stays nice and flat. The squat, we're going to start from the clean position, so we've got to clean the kettlebells back up. Don't smash your fingers. I like to lift the fingertips up and then bring the fingers together over the handles. Feet underneath your shoulders. Take the hips back. Drop the thighs to parallel. Power back up to the start. And then the press, also starting from that clean position. You're going to engage your core, engage everything, press up overhead, bring it back in tight. Really focus on the engagement of this midsection so you can protect the lower back. We've got 10 repetitions going through each exercise on this first set. So prepare yourself for the clean. We're going to go through this first set two times, 10 reps each. Get set up. Three, two, and go. One. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. I'm just going to hold them up here and get ready for my squat. Going down in 3, 2, and 1. 1. 2. 3. 4. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Take a couple breaths here. I'm just going to keep with it. Keep the kettlebells in the rack. 10 presses. 3, 2, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. Take a few moments to catch your breath. There's a lot of exertion involved in double kettlebell work. It's surprising how high your heart rate shoots up by doing these exercises. Weight training and cardio exercise combined, extremely effective. Going back through the second time, I'm thinking at this point I'm going to set the kettlebells down between each exercise, give myself a few more breaths between each one. Set your kettlebells up. We've got the clean first, going to 10 again. 3, 2, and go. There's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Come up, take a few breaths. Moving on to the squat. So we set the kettlebells down for a few breaths. The good thing is that we get a few more breaths between each exercise. The bad news is that we have to clean the kettlebells back up to continue. So get set up for your clean. We got to clean the kettlebells, then moving into the squat. And clean. Sit up your feet, sit up your hands. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. We got the press coming up. Get your breaths in. Get the heart rate back down. Now on these presses, as you get tired, you don't want to go to failure when you're pressing a weight overhead. So if you're reaching failure, just stop. No harm done. You've done your best. Also, recruit the hips a little bit. A little pop from the hips helps transfer momentum up to the hands. Makes it a little bit easier to hoist those kettlebells overhead. 10 reps here. Let's clean them up. Tight rack position. Get your feet set up. Get your mind right. Engage your core. And go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And 10. Grab a towel, wipe off that sweat, sip some water, I'll come back for the explanation of the exercises for set two. For set two, we've got three more exercises. This time, instead of 10 reps each, though, we'll be doing just 5 reps each. The first exercise is the alternating clean. Basically, it's the same as the regular clean, except one arm hangs down while the other arm comes up into the rack position. You'll tone the belly, draw the shoulder blades back, engage the core, power up from the hips. Only one arm comes up into the rack position. You'll take it all the way back down, and then the other arm comes up while the other arm hangs down, and that's one repetition. The second exercise is the lunge. To start from the lunge, you're going to need both the kettlebells up in the rack position. So clean them both. Now I find the rear lunge is the easiest on the knees. So with this extra weight added, we'll do a rear lunge. Step back, lower, step up. Then the other leg steps back, lower, come up. Getting both sides is one repetition. And then the third exercise of the second set is the press again. We've already done that last round, but like the other exercises in this set, we're just doing 5 reps each. So let's do this. 5 reps, alternating cleans. Get your set up. Tone your core, find your stance. 3, 2, and go. There's one. And 1, 2, 3, 4, there's 5. Come up, take a couple breaths. 5 lunges. Clean the kettlebells up. Get your feet underneath your hips. Take the leg back. Use your core to lower. There's 1. There's 2. Set up. There's one. And there's one. Two. There's three. There's four. And five. One more exercise of this workout. Oh, I take that back. We've got a bonus exercise. But we'll keep that under wraps for a moment. Work to control your breath. We've got the presses to complete this set. Find your stance. Set up. Clean the bells. Position the feet. Ready the core. And go. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. Set the kettlebells down. Catch your breath. For the bonus exercise, you're just going to need one bell. That bonus exercise is going to be 20 reps of the two-hand kettlebell swing. Get your bell set up, find your stance. Get ready. And go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Woo! All right. Grab a towel, grab a sip of water real quick, and we'll come back. We'll stretch out and cool down. All right, nice work. Let's go right into some huggers. Alternate which arm goes on top. Loosen up the chest, back, and shoulders. Few more here. And good, let those come to a stop. I'm gonna sweep the arms up overhead, lengthen the spine, pull the biceps further back than the ears, and release. Inhale, exhale, breathe in, and out. One more time. Step the feet wide, swan dive into forward fold. Feel that stretch in the back and hamstrings, the lower back and hamstrings. Firm the legs up, stretch the legs, lengthen the spine away from the legs. Keep everything engaged and fold back in. Halfway lift and lengthen. Pivot to your right 90 degrees. Draw back on your right hip. Now, if your hamstrings are too tight to touch the floor, come up onto your shins if you need to. Bend the front knee, step the back one back. Little twist. Loosen up the lower back some more. Lower that twist, drop the back knee. Bring your hands to your forward thigh and sink forwards, stretching out the hip flexor. Pivot to your left 90 degrees. Keep your right knee bent and your left leg straight. Try to get the heel of your right foot to the floor. Open up the groins in the hips. Shift to the other side. Pivot left 90 degrees. Drop the right knee to the floor. Come up onto the forward thigh. Sink the hips forward. Stretch the front of your right hip. Hands hands to the floor or to your shin. Straighten both legs. Draw your left hip back. Pivot back forward. Fold forward. Turn your heels in and toes out. Drop into a squat. Open up the hips, a little shifting from side to side. One more, wide leg, forward fold. Bend the knees, roll up slowly. Step the feet together, reach up, stretch up, lengthen out, and release your arms to your sides. Nice work, that was a tough one. That was Kettleplex, double down. I'm Johnny, I'll see you again real soon.